Uncle Chunt.
So I just went and saw Logan today, and I've had a mixed bag of emotions. I must say, I'm not the kind of guy that would usually wear his emotions on his sleeve. I tend to ignore my emotions. I tend to bottle things up and stew on things. But today, I must say, man, Logan really gets you to the core if you've been a fan of Hugh Jackman's Wolverine over the last almost two decades, as well as Patrick Stewart's Professor X. This is the final run for Logan. Hugh Jackman's final movie as Wolverine. So he's been saying for a long time that he wants to, you know, move on from it and retire from that character. And without saying too much, I'd like to think that this movie gave him the send-off that this character deserves. And I do believe that. Right off the bat, we're used to seeing Wolverine and Hugh Jackman in these X-Men films as this unstoppable berserker barrage of a type of character, where bullets don't stop him, being thrown around doesn't stop him. He just regenerates from any wound. It doesn't matter what's thrown at him, he just comes back, he just heals right up. He's like a Terminator, he just doesn't stop, you can't stop him. And we're just used to seeing that character on screen as a Wolverine, but this one, right from the get-go, he's on the last rope. He seems to be damaged, in more ways than one. This isn't the same Logan Wolverine that we're used to. He's aged. It's hard to see. It's hard to watch this character that you're used to seeing as some bigger-than-life character. You just can't stop him, and he owns the screen that he's on all the time. And he does it again here. He totally owns this movie. Probably the most impressed I've been with Hugh Jackman and his acting performance in any movie. I mean, I like a lot of his movies, and a lot of his movies I've seen have made me go, wow, like, he's really good. But this one in particular, he really did justice as his final run as Wolverine. You just really feel like this character doesn't want to be around anymore. And we started getting that story thread from, like, Wolverine, I don't think Wolverine Origins, but more or less the Wolverine, the one before this one, where he just wanted out. He didn't want to be around anymore, which is understandable when you know the character and what he's been through. Everyone that he's ever loved has died. You know, moving on life to life to life, losing everyone that you've loved over the centuries that he's lived. And, you know, you just get jack of that. Like, you keep losing your loved ones, and bad things keep happening to those you love. And being with his healing factor, he would be technically immortal. The way they kind of run into that in this film, without spoiling things, is quite clever. I never really thought about it that way. So I bought it, the reason why they're going with it in this film. It's going to be hard to talk about this film without spoiling anything, but I'm going to do my best. Anything that I do spoil, I'll cut out when I edit this video, so don't worry, I'm not going to slip up and leave it in. This is probably the most realistic film we've ever seen in the Wolverine franchise, and that's saying a lot since it deals with mutants and whatnot, but part of the plot that we know, this isn't a spoiler, that mutants aren't really a thing anymore. Logan and Professor X are pretty much one of the very few remaining mutants around, and it's a very dark take on it. It's a very dire world that you see their mutant type of kind live in this film. So Logan's living his life, he's a limo driver, just doing jobs, just, you know, existing, basically held up in a little hidey hole, just doing day to day, looking for his way out, and he's looking after Professor X. And that kind of relationship that you see in this film really kind of lends to that you really see the two care about each other. Like, ever since X-Men, the first X-Men, where Professor X took him in and became a mentor of sorts, this movie kind of goes full circle with that, and it's really cool to see. I was really surprised about how I was taken with this film, just because I know all of those X-Men films with these characters in it and how they've come over time. And not only because, the other thing is that, you know, when an actor gives up a role that's been playing this long, it's usually because of an age thing, where you get to a point where you're like, okay, I'm getting too old to play this role. And to see that as as a watcher for all these years, and you're like, oh, like, it's really sad because it kind of brings in the mortality of it. And then you start thinking about yourself, you're like, oh man, like, they're getting old and I'm getting old. So, you know, I'm only 31, but whatever. It's, you can't help but feel that. We've kind of, you've grown up with these characters in these films over the years, and you're like, oh damn. Oh damn, a lot of time has passed. Oh damn. This movie doesn't go out of its way to be emotional on purpose, but the way it goes about itself can't make you feel otherwise about what's going on. And it's hard to explain without spoiling it. But there were just a lot of moments when you're like, oh, like, what you're seeing is, it's just brutal. Like, brutal in a lot of ways. And if you don't come out of this film with any sense of emotion in you, then I don't know what's wrong with you. I appreciate this film a lot, and I didn't expect to feel as much as I had coming out of it. Now, on the other side of things, the violence, like, this movie earns its R rating with both hands holding on and annihilating everything. Everything that you wanted to see Wolverine do, more or less, happens in this movie. Man, the amount of times you see his claws get stuck into someone's head, or a limb come off, or just blood gushing somewhere, or you just, like, you remember those other X-Men films, you're like, oh, like, that fight scene could have been a lot cool, like, oh, if I was Wolverine, I would have chopped her arm off or something like that. This will satisfy you, and I was satisfied by the action in this. Now, that the twists in this film, I did not see coming. I'll say that. It's part of the violence. There's a certain portion of the film where something's going down and it just suddenly twists. And it works. I did not expect it. And the way they went about it, they didn't spoon feed it to you either. You just kind of have to come to your own conclusion as to what happened. And the movie does feed you those nuggets throughout the film, but it doesn't just go, this is what's happening because of this, yum yum. And I appreciate that when a movie does that. It's one problem that I've had with Marvel Studios movies, where they're Marvel films. Every one of those films kind of spoon feeds you what's happening, as if there's always one exhibitional character who's just there to feed you about what's going on. And I don't like that. I find it a little insulting. I like to put the pieces together while I'm watching it. And this film does that, and I appreciate that. Now, the X-23, man, she kicks ass. And I think what they did in this film, considering how young this actress is, that's ballsy, man. Like, that's ballsy. For a young kid to be around that kind of violence, yes, it's film. Yes, it would have been explained to her, this is what we're going to do. Here are the props. You know, here are the limbs. This is blood. This is what that looks like. Blah, blah, blah. Here's what you're going to do to this man. You know, I could only imagine how they kind of directed her about it. I mean, that you have to be careful with that. And what they did with her and how well she did it was amazing. The scenes that she's in are intense. And just her on her own, even when she's not even speaking, you're just like, holy crap, this girl is intense. There was a lot to say about this movie. I did plan on doing a spoiler talk video, but I thought otherwise. I would rather you go out and watch this movie and make your own viewing without really being told what it is and what it's like. I posted something on Facebook earlier today as soon as I came out of the film. Basically, I overreacted my statement as to how emotional I was about this film, just because that's just my sense of humor. But it's not too far from the truth. You know, had I allowed myself completely to go nuts, I probably would have been a lot more emotional than I was coming out. But that's nothing to say otherwise. Like, I did feel some churning about, this is the end. And that sense of that, it's like never seeing someone again. That kind of feeling when you know that that's going to be the last time you see someone that you've been around for so long. It's kind of the best way that I can explain that kind of feeling without spoiling the movie altogether. I've said that a lot, like, about not spoiling it, but I'm just trying to be careful about what I say. So, look, I really enjoyed the film. I'm going to buy this on Blu-ray. I don't really own any Blu-ray X-Men movies. X-Men movies I've liked, I've seen every one of them at the movies, but they've never really been my thing that I'll throw money down on a lot. So I want this movie on Blu-ray. It's a good movie. It's a great movie first, and a comic book movie second. And they kind of address that in the movie as well. So yeah, go see this movie. It's really good. If you can't enjoy something in this film, it's an R-rated film, but if you can't take away something from this movie that you enjoyed, I mean, that's your own problem. It's something else. It's very special. So hard to explain, but it's like a perfect mixture of just a great, solid movie with a lot of heart in it. So I recommend you go see it and let me know what you think when you afterwards. Just come back here and go, Chunt, you were right. Oh my God, I brought a box of tissues with me. So I'm going to wrap this one up and upload it. I look forward to what your comments are. Come back after you've seen it and let's have a yarn. And yeah, I'll catch you on the next video. And keep an eye out on my social media for any Twitch streams coming up. If you haven't followed me on other things, just search Uncle Chunt on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. I'm on those. I'm usually always on one of those social media outlets. So whenever I post something, I'll be putting them up there. And if you haven't already, with the YouTube subscription button, just click that. And make sure you hit the bell as well so you get notified when I upload. And I'll catch you on the next video. Toodaloos. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it. If you haven't already, please subscribe and check out some of my other recent videos. Have a good one. Boom.